Hello everyone, myself Prashant Awachat, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering Department, GHRAET Academy of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. Friends, today we are going to discuss about the cast irons. Basically, cast irons are the alloys of iron and carbon containing 2 to 6.67% carbon. Normally, cast irons are the cheaper material as compared to the steels, since the cast irons are produced from near about 50% steel scrap, 35% foundry returns, which are generated from the runner risers and pouring basins of the already poured castings, and 50% high percent carbon pig irons. Okay. Now, these cast irons cannot be forged, rolled or pressed into the desired shape. They can be only formed by using melting and casting process. That is why the name suggests cast irons. Okay, friends, now on the basis of appearance and microstructures, cast irons are classified as white cast irons, then gray cast iron, then nodular cast iron, then malleable cast iron, next one is chilled cast iron, and finally alloy cast iron. Now, we will discuss one by one, starting from the white cast iron. White cast irons are the basic forms of cast iron. When we break the component of white cast iron, it appears white in color. The fracture appears white in color just because of the all the carbon present in white cast iron is in combined form, that is in cementite form. These cast irons are very much harder in nature, producing near about 350 to 500 BHN hardness, and they cannot be machined by the normal machining processes. So, the final shape of the cast iron can be finished by using the grinding process, and these cast irons cooling can be easily explained with the help of iron carbide diagram, since their carbon, all the carbon present in the combined form. These cast irons are normally used for the liners, covers, road roller surfaces, etc., since their high hardness properties. Now, the next one is the gray cast iron. The gray cast irons are the cheapest among all the cast irons and all the alloys of iron and carbon, since they are produced with very large amount of scrap. These cast irons are differ from the white cast iron in the sense, when a freshly broken surface, we look at the freshly broken surface of the gray cast iron, it appears gray in color. That is because of the free carbon or the free graphite present in the gray cast iron. This free graphite comes from the process of the graphitization. Normally, this gray cast iron consists quite larger amount of carbon than the white cast iron and the silicon and the manganese also. Normally, the gray cast iron consists 3.2% carbon, 1.6% silicon and 0.9% manganese, and the other elements like sulfur with 0.1%. Now, since this carbon and sulfur both are the graphitizing elements, whatever the combined carbon present in the white cast iron, that can be freed by using this carbon and silicon, normally called as a carbon equivalents, which represents carbon, total carbon percentage plus 1/3 of silicon and the other elements. Now, this white cast gray cast irons having very good damping properties as compared to the white cast iron, and excellent machining properties, since the free graphites are present there. The graphitization is done with the help of carbon and silicon, and this carbon and silicon breaks the cementite matrix and the graphites are formed. So, normally the liquid melt is treated with the inoculants at the end of the pouring, and we will get the gray cast iron with the good damping capacities and good hardness properties. The gray cast irons, as per the standards, are classified as Fg 200, Fg 250, Fg 300, Fg 260, Fg 350. This Fg suggests the flake graphites, which are the free graphites present in the grey cast iron, and this 200 suggests the tensile strength in Newton per mm square. This free graphite looks like in this form, that these are called as flakes of graphites if you observe the microstructure of grey cast iron. Now, this free graphite is totally responsible for the machining properties of grey cast iron. Normally, these flakes, the formation of these flakes depends upon the amount of carbon and silicon present in the grey cast iron. Grey cast iron normally have 3% to carbon, and it may vary from 3.2 to 3.8%. Now, the next one is the nodular cast iron. Friends, nodular cast iron is quite a bridge between the steels and the cast irons. Since these cast irons having very poor properties of elongation and ductility, this can be overcome by the production of nodular cast iron. Normally, the nodular cast iron consists of the graphites in the form of spheroids or nodules. So, this grey cast iron melt, when treated with the magnesium, we get the nodules or spheroids of graphites, which disrupts, which less disrupt the steel like matrix which is produced in the grey cast iron, and gives the excellent tensile strength and elongation properties in the cast irons. Normally, this magnesium treatment is done by using the various ferrosilicon magnesiums, nickel magnesiums, or sometimes with the copper magnesium. This nodular cast iron consists quite higher percentage of carbon, normally 4.2 to 4.3% carbon and 2% silicon. But the sulfur amount which was present in the grey cast iron, it is not present in the nodular cast iron, since the magnesium is very effective to the sulfur, and they forms the magnesium sulfides, which is not desirable in the cast irons. So, therefore, this magnesium sulfide which is produced in the nodular cast iron, if the sulfur is available there, then the nodules formation is not possible. Then before that, the grey cast iron liquid melt is treated with the soda, and this reduce the sulfur from the liquid metal of grey cast iron, and then we get the regular shape nodules or spheroids. The nodular cast iron, sometimes called as Hg irons also, because of the spheroidal graphites, and as per the standards, they are termed as Hg Hg 400/10, Hg 400/12, Hg 500/6, Hg 600/4, Hg 700/3, and Hg 800/2. Now, you can see that this Hg represents the spheroidal graphite. Then this 400 represent the tensile strength in Newton per mm square, and the remaining part 10, 12, 6, these are the elongations which are produced in the nodular cast iron. These cast irons have sufficient hardness also as compared to the grey cast iron, and they produce a quite good elongation properties. Now, the next one is the malleable cast iron. This malleable cast irons are basically produced from the white cast iron, and they are produced by using the heat treatment called as malleabilizing heat treatment. Since the white cast iron's elongation is very less means it is less than 1%, and the malleable cast iron which is produced, which gives near about 6 to 20% elongation. This can be produced by heating the white cast iron pieces in the furnace slowly up to 900 to 950 degrees Celsius. Normally, this white cast iron pieces are heated in a furnace up to 900 to 950 degrees Celsius. And then holding at this temperature for a longer duration of time. This duration may be from 24 hours to several days. Okay. Due to this longer holding, the white cast iron, which is having a rough rag microstructure, this rough rag microstructure converted into the irregular shape spheroids or nodules called as rosettes of malleable cast iron. Now, this irregular shape nodules gives excellent elongation properties, near about 6 to 20% of elongation. And this elongation properties of malleable cast iron are used for the various purposes. As the name suggests, it is a malleable cast iron, but it cannot be forged or rolled or by press into the thin sheets, but it just having the higher elongation properties, that is why it is called as malleable cast iron as compared to the other cast irons which gives very less elongation properties. Now, the next one is the chilled cast iron. As we have already discussed, the white cast iron is the hardest in nature, and the grey cast iron having comparatively less hardness as compared to the white cast iron. This chilled cast iron basically is the combination of white cast iron and grey cast iron. Now, when we take a chill test, that a piece is a metal piece, a cast iron piece is chilled or cooled very fastly, we get white cast iron on the surface of the piece, and then at the depth when we move towards the center, we get the grey cast iron. This happens because the sudden cooling stops the graphitization of the cast iron, and the surface of that piece becomes white cast iron, which is provides excellent hardness properties. And when we move towards the center, we find that the formation of graphite starts, that is the flake formation starts, and at the center sufficient amount of flakes are available as compared to the surface. While the surface is completely hard, just because of the not present of the graphite, free graphite and a combined form of carbon, that is the cementite. This cast iron provides the both properties of white cast iron and grey cast iron, that is at the surface your piece is very hard, and at the center you are providing the very good damping properties. Normally these cast irons are having carbon percentage and silicon percentage quite similar to your grey cast iron. The next one is the alloy cast iron. Alloy cast irons are the type of cast iron where the corrosion resistance and hardness properties of the already poured cast irons or already studied cast irons can be increased by having heavily alloying elements. Normally, these alloy cast irons are classified as nickel hard and nickel resist. This nickel hard are produced from white cast iron, where the hardness properties of white cast iron can be increased by the addition of nickel. Now, nickel is a costlier material. Obviously, the alloy cast irons which are produced from the nickel will have the higher cost as compared to the other cast irons. This nickel hard normally having near about 4 to 3% nickel, which increases the hardness of white cast iron to 500 to 700 BHN, which was already 350 to 500 BHN. Now, once this nickel, once this nickel is added, they can produce the sites for the graphitization and the graphites are formed. To avoid this, we use some amount of chromium, which is a carbide former. This chromium overcomes the graphitization and stops the formation of graphite and gives nickel hard white cast iron with the good hardness properties. Normally the chromium is added 1 to 3% in the nickel hard. The next one is the nickel resist. Nickel resist is the cast iron, alloy cast iron, which is produced from the gray cast iron, where the corrosion resistance properties of gray cast iron, which was fairly very low, that can be increased by using the nickel resist. Okay. In nickel resist, we add near about 14 to 15% nickel, where this nickel resistance gives excellent corrosion resistance properties to the gray cast iron. Now, students, today we will end with the cast irons. Now, in the next class, we will learn about the non-ferrous alloys, that is brass and bronzes. Okay, thank you.